Welcome back, my fellow Gevonians. To kick things off, we got some great news to celebrate. After 10 consecutive days trading above $1, Gevo has regained its compliance with Nasdaq.
I'm not fucking leaving! The show goes on!
This means the risk of delisting is behind us, at least for now. But with recent positive developments like their latest acquisitions and the expected approval of the DOE loan for the Net Zero One project, I'm quite hopeful Gevo won't face this issue ever again. Now, let's dive into the recently released news about Gevo's acquisition of CultivateAI, another genius move by Gevo's management. Gevo's acquisition of CultivateAI isn't just another purchase, it's a strategic step that will give Gevo significant advantages in the renewable energy and biofuel space. By integrating CultivateAI's advanced AI-driven platform into Verity Tracking, Gevo will unlock a wealth of new capabilities. And in this video, I will highlight the top 4 competitive advantages Gevo gains from this acquisition. 1. Seamless data integration and automation with John Deere. One of the standout aspects of CultivateAI's platform is its integration with John Deere Operations Center. This partnership enables the automatic download of field boundaries and operation maps, eliminating the need for manual data transfers. And according to John Deere, CultivateAI aggregates and cleans volumes of machine sensor data, enabling easy, unbiased insights of your products. This automation provides Gevo with powerful data at the field level, allowing for better decision-making, which directly impacts carbon intensity tracking through Verity. The ability to automatically collect and analyze such data ensures that every step of the supply chain is accurately monitored and reported from feedstock to final biofuel. 2. Real-time insights and enhanced supply chain efficiency. CultivateAI's ability to process and analyze real-time data means Gevo can now optimize its supply chain like never before. Verity Tracking will benefit from this data to better track carbon intensity across biofuels, feedstocks, and RNG, renewable natural gas. With detailed GPS-based maps that track planting, harvesting, and other agricultural activities, Gevo can reduce the carbon intensity of its products even further. The precision farming capabilities brought by CultivateAI ensure that resources are used efficiently, leading to greater sustainability and lower operational costs. 3. Unmatched carbon intensity tracking and verification. Verity has always been a leader in carbon intensity tracking, but with CultivateAI integrated, this ability goes to the next level. The platform allows for the measurement of carbon intensity at the field level and throughout the entire biofuel lifecycle. This eliminates the issues of double counting carbon credits and ensures transparency throughout the supply chain. For companies seeking verified carbon reduction solutions, this means Gevo's biofuels will stand out as having verified low carbon footprints, making them highly attractive in both regulatory and market-driven environments. 4. Strategic partnerships and scalable growth. This acquisition also opens the door for Gevo to form new strategic partnerships. With the DOE loan approval on the horizon, and now the integration of CultivateAI into Verity Tracking, Gevo is becoming an even more attractive partner for companies focused on reducing carbon emissions. This new tech will allow Gevo to better scale its operation and expand the net zero concepts to additional facilities, maximizing its market presence and production capacity in sustainable aviation fuel. With Nasdaq compliance restored and the DOE loan just around the corner, it's clear Gevo's management is making smart strategic moves to position the company as a leader in the sustainable fuels industry. So, well played, Dr. Gruber. If you found this analysis helpful, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to stay updated on Gevo's journey. And please remember, this video is for informational and entertainment purposes only, and you should not take it as any kind of financial advice. Thanks for watching. Until next time, bye-bye.